次は嵐山、嵐山駅終点です。
Very traditional layout. You can use your shoes here when you go enter the room, so you can leave your shoes.
Got it.
Okay, and this is layout for the futon, how to sleep. South way is better. North way is not good for Japanese.
Oh, really?
Yes.
to
this is, yes, this is north side.
Oh. Winter, yeah.
It's not good to put on the head.
Oh, so. Is it like dangerous?
Yeah, it's meaning, you know, some people dead, they put the north side.
Yes.
That's why.
Good to know.
It is same, huh?
Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. So, welcome back to another video. Today, we are in Kyoto. I came here to see the Momiji, which is like maple leaves changing colors. It's literally the perfect time of year. It's so hard to pinpoint when to come here, especially for like cherry blossoms. Cherry blossoms die so fast. And for some odd reason, like the fall leaves all around Japan are really off. Like the timing is off. So this was really hard to pinpoint, but I think I got here at the perfect time. We just got to the Airbnb, checked all in. I'm gonna give you guys a tour really quick. Welcome to the videos. Not really sure how much I'm gonna be vlogging, what exactly I'm gonna be filming, because I'm gonna be doing a lot of the same stuff that I've done in my other Kyoto vlogs. I will link the videos to the other Kyoto vlogs down below. I freaking love those. One of them was shot in spring.
But it's so freaking beautiful in spring. There's just shrine gates and cherry blossoms and it's so freaking beautiful.
So I freaking love those videos. But yeah, Kyoto's gonna look very different because we're here for the fall leaves, which I don't think I've filmed before. I have been here for the fall leaves, but I don't think I've ever shown it on my channel. So it's gonna be fun. I am here on business and I also can't wait to show you guys a project that I've been working on. I'm excited. Kyoto's like my favorite place ever. All right, so we made it to the Airbnb that we're gonna be staying at for the rest of this trip. It's right near Arashiyama, which if you guys have seen any of my other videos, you know that is my absolute favorite place in Kyoto and it's walking distance. So there's gonna be a lot of Arashiyama going on in this trip. Let me give you guys a tour of this room really quick.
Come on in.
So this house is actually located in the back of the main house. It's like a separate little spot. Right when you walk in is one of those traditional kitchens. So this is like usually a dirt floor or like a stone floor, I think. If I'm not mistaken, this is a dirt floor, but it's not like the type of dirt that like flies up everywhere. Very, very traditional. I mean, the sink is made of stone. Microwave's down here. Got a little fridge. This is the kitchen area. There's a little table in here, and then you have to take off your shoes to go into the rest of the place. Yeah, these rooms are so popular in Japan. It's literally just like a tatami room with like one dresser, and then the futons are in the closet. So there's nothing in this room. It's very, very common. And this is the last room. It's the main room. Basically, you put the futons in here. It opens up to the garden.
Little table and cushions for sitting.
Rock garden on this side, and then down the hallway is the bathroom. So this is the toilet room. Where am I going through my makeup and my wigs? I guess I literally have to do it on the toilet. This is the mirror.
Hi.
You pooping?
And this is the sink. Oh my god, does it even go hot?
Oh, no, no, no.
Oh my god, it's cold. And the bathroom, which is very nice. Here is the bathroom, which is the reason why we chose this place, other than the location. A very nice bathtub. It's like all
just
automated.
Okay.
And there's like windows all around it, but obviously there's like a little fence so nobody can see in. So this is the engawa, which I am obsessed with. It's like a little hallway that separates house from like the garden outside area. But yeah, it's a really chill little spot. I am super excited because this is a really nice area. Like I said, it's very close to Arashiyama. But I think today we're actually gonna go up north and check out some of the temples and shrines in that area. I was actually super excited to stay at this place. I wanted to do a bit of research because I have been really interested in buying a traditional home in Japan, especially a Kyomachiya or a Kyoto Machiya. Machiyas are traditional wooden townhouses that were really popular in the past. Because Kyoto was not bombed in the war, 1904, a lot of these machiyas are still around. In order to renovate one, I really needed to understand how they were built, so I was taking a lot of photos and paying attention to like everything in the house. I cannot wait to buy my own house in Japan, but if you're like me and you're interested in this type of topic, there is a guy on YouTube. His channel is Good Old Houses Japan, and he actually bought and renovated a Kyoto machiya. If you come to Japan, I highly recommend staying in a traditional place like this. If you guys are interested, I'm gonna have like the links and everything down below in the description box for this place that I stayed at. So we come to Ryoanji. It's one of the places that we just stumbled upon. Like the last time we was walking around here, I was like, oh, what's that? And then boom, like one of the most beautiful temples ever. Look at the leaves. We're just gonna walk around and that's gonna be it for today.